civil libertarians are concerned about powers that governments still have 19 years later that have never been repealed because of the war on terrorism. And now we've got a war on a virus who, and I have to say it again, according to the government data, this is not my opinion, it's what the government data will tell you when you look at the government data, the lethality of this virus is in the same range as an annual flu, and it is not a pandemic like what we had in 1918 and the other pandemics, 1957, 1968. It's nowhere close to that at all. It's much closer to an annual flu. But we have to wage war against this coronavirus, COVID-19. In Manitoba, which has 1.something million people, 75 people in Manitoba have died of COVID, which of course is very sad and tragic. Although I would argue no less sad and tragic than the 11,191 Manitobans who died of cancer and canceled surgeries, alcoholism, drug overdoses, suicides, and other causes. And so we're coming up. We're in the month of November. We're getting ever closer. I'm not going to make a promise for a date, but we're getting ever closer to the release of the Justice Center's paper on lockdown harms. What we have discovered to date is that the lockdowns are killing more people than what the virus has killed. And of course, politicians love to say, oh, well, the reason that, you know, we don't have huge numbers of people dying of COVID is because of the lockdown measures. So, you know, give us a pat on the back. We've saved thousands of people by having these lockdown measures. And that's why the COVID numbers are so small. In Canada, every year, 300,000 people died in Canada the year ending June 30th, 2020. 300,000 Canadians died, which you'd expect in a country of 38 million, right? It's not, It's not too far-fetched. And so that's 25,000 Canadians a month, 300,000 a year. How many COVID deaths? Very close to 10,000. I don't know if we're just under or just over, but 10,000 COVID deaths. 2 years ago, the annual flu in 2018 claimed 8,500 lives. So 2020, we've got COVID claiming 10,000 lives. 8,500, 10,000, is that a huge difference in a context of 300,000 people dying every year? Obviously not.